Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in methodology preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to render exposition of the Gnostic author of Philip, translated by Wesley W. Eisenberg, part 86. So here is Philip is describing the compatibility, because if you are not compatible, you don't go well together. So here he is giving an example. The human being has intercourse with the human being. The horse has intercourse with the horse. The ass with the ass. That means donkey with the donkey. Members of a race usually have associated with those of like race. So people are like-minded people, they'll go together. So spirit mingles with spirit. So spirit mingled with spirit means that the things of the Holy Spirit are word, when His word is preached, it is being of spirit, is understood only by people of the spirit, not the once-born people. Remember, Peter was once-born, he could not understand the gospel. So that's why at the Last Supper, Peter requested Jesus to not only wash his feet, but also wash his hands and head, so he can have gospel. But at Pentecost, when he was paid his wage, you know, those 12 were the workers in the vineyard of God. In the evening, the master came. Master is God. He asked the foreman, give the wages to your workers. Foreman was Christ Jesus. So then he gave wages to each one the same, which was Holy Spirit with capital S, that made all the workers twin brother of Jesus. Before those were younger brother, then they became the twin brother. So things of the spirit are known to the people of spirit, not to the once born people. So these parables I am explaining, they are understood by the people of spirit, whereas the once born people, they can't understand. So they will say, oh, this is rubbish, nothing, you know. So, because they can't understand it. They only understand what is written or what their teacher tells them. They can't think of their own. So, they are blindfolded by their teacher. And the Jewish people, Messianic Jew, have blindfolded the people that don't read anything which is not... we haven't put it together in the Bible. So what did you read? Only the Bible, not the Gnostic Gospel or Thomas or Philip or anyone. So that's how they have put this blindfolded the people, and they only know what is have been they given. If you are born a human being, it is the human race being who will love you. Sorry, so spirit mingles with spirit and thought consorts with the thought and light shares with the light. So if you have the knowledge of gospel truth, light, then you share the light with other people, which is called philo love. If you are born a human being, it is the human being who will love you. That means sons of man are loved by sons of man. Not the sons of Satan won't love the human being. So if you become a spirit, it is the spirit which will be joined to you. So if you become spirit, then the spirit become your The Holy Spirit with capital S become your teacher, or that join you in your heart. So through intuition, then you learn the gospel. If you become light, it is the light which will share with you. So if you become light, mean if you become the if you become sealed to serve God and you are capable of preaching gospel, then the other people who preach gospel, then they can share with you. You learn from them and they learn from you. If you become one of those who belong above, it is those who belong above who will rest upon you. Those who belong above mean apostles. Those who have reached the highest stage, spiritual stage. So when you become apostle, then the apostles will love you. And these ordinary people, they will laugh at you. Remember one of the story I was hearing, that one of the apostles, he went through a village town saying, I have invaluable goods. I give them free, any buyer. And these invaluable goods were gospel truth, which you give free because you receive it free. So this is the thing, that not everybody is a customer for the gospel truth. So you have to be lucky to find one. If you become horse or ass or bull or dog or sheep or another of the animals which are outside or below, then neither human being nor spirit nor thought nor light will be able to love you. So if you are not part of this system and you are outside the system, that means if you are a animal, horse or anything, you know, which is a outside, mean that where you can't contact them, or so if you become horse or ass or bull or dog or sheep or another of the animal which are outside or below, then neither human being nor spirit nor thought nor light will be able to love you. That means if you are not this living gospel is for the living people. Living people are those who are present with you, who are with you, not that somebody is in another country or another thing. They won't love you because the gospel is cannot be taught like letters in the university. It is preached face to face so that you can iron out the problem. That's why it's called double-edged sword. So if you happen to, as I'm doing, so preach gospel, then some people may not understand. And then they won't love you, you know. So they are outside. Only when you are together, then you understand. And also people who are not compatible. Neither those who belong above nor those who belong within will be able to rest in you. Neither those who belong above or those who belong within will be able to rest in you, and you have no part in them. That means in order to have a part with you, then you must have face-to-face discussion. So then they know then you are iron out the things. Thank you.